Etty say.
Hello.
Are you Ghanaian?
No, I'm Nigerian.
This is Peter, and that's my sweetheart.
You remind me of my family.
Really? Oh, that's interesting. Can you tell me more about the family?
Back home in Nigeria, I've heard a lot of things about the United Kingdom. And as a child, I fantasized day and night about London. It was a dream come true when I was told we were relocating to London. My father had it all planned out, and as a captain, we followed him.
You're welcome to London.
Oh, thank you very much, sir. Thank you.
Yes.
London City Airport. Oh, God.
I hope you all had a safe flight. Yeah?
Well, we thank God. Thank God. Except my daughters that are tired.
Oh, yeah, yeah, it's a long flight.
A bit tired, you are?
Yeah. Which country did you all come from?
Nigeria.
Ah, Nigeria.
Yes, yes.
Nigeria, a lot of Nigerians in this country.
Wow. They call it the giant of Africa.
Oh yes, you are. Yes. Nigeria, good people, good people.
Thank God.
Good people.
Okay. Is that a church or a cathedral?
It's a church.
It's a church.
Big one.
It's a big, big church here.
We are here.
Ah, thank you.
You're welcome.
How much is it?
Yeah, £50, please.
£50?
Yes.
Can't we pay £40? You know we are just new in this country.
Nope. It's £50. We pay per mileage here.
Honey, he says it's £50, oh.
Sugar, give it to him.
But can you give me a rough estimate this one is in Naira?
Man, the moment you keep converting your home currency to the money here, you will end up not buying anything. The time that you landed in Itro, your home currency ceases to exist. So here is the land of pound and pence. £50, please.
Can we get down now?
Here we go. Yes, thank you so much.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon.
We are expatriates from Africa. We are looking for this address.
May I see?
Number 45.
Wow. We are neighbors. That's just the house. So, what country in Africa?
Nigeria.
Nigeria?
Yes, ma'am.
What state?
Osun State.
Osun State. Wow. We are just neighbors. I am from Oshogbo.
Oshogbo?
Yeah. Oh, that's so good. You're welcome.
Thank you, ma.
That is the house.
This is the house.
Yes.
How we've been looking. Guys, that's a house. Hold on, I'm coming. Oh, Grandma, he's coming. Come in, Grandma. Thank you very much. What is this?
I've come to welcome you with this.
Thank you very much, Ma. Please come in, come in, come in, come in.
Us feel so much at home. You are very welcome. My little angel, do you still need some more soup?
My mommy said I should behave myself and I shouldn't ask for more.
Mommy, why are you stopping her?
Grandma, Oliver said they love your meal, but if you give these children free hand, you have no food left at home.
Don't worry about me. I have a lot left where this one came from. You are all welcome to this land of opportunities. I must warn you, these opportunities come with temptation.
Temptation?
Yes.
What do you mean by temptation?
Some people come to this land and they forget their roots. They start to live this life as if there's no tomorrow. Some even forget how they fasted and prayed before they came to this country.
We have come to this land with an unshakable focus and determination, and we are not going to settle for less.
Amen. Let me share a secret with you. What I'm about to do is what the devil hates most. And that's what he fights most. Can we rise up with me, please? Thank you. Mercy, give me your hand. In unity, though you are four, you should stand as one. In unity of spirit, when you decree a thing, it will stand. Also in unity, when you rebuke the devil, he will flee. But remember, the devil uses the system of this land to bring disunity in homes, to break unity, to break love.
Mercy, give me your hand.
When you speak in one language as a family, there is no limitation to the height that you can get to in this land. God has given you two daughters, Mercy and Grace. I pray that they will not depart from you in Jesus' name.
Oh my dear, this is the United Kingdom you guys have been dreaming about.
Yes, so who are ready? All we need now is a job so that we can start working and be able to settle our bills and cater for demands from home.
That's not a problem at all. All I have to do is to give you some numbers to agencies. They will call you for registration. And before you know it, you started doing extra shifts for more money to begin to roll in.
Oh,
yeah.
Thank you very much. I trust you.
Anyway, how are the children?
At home, of course. They are old enough to look after themselves.
Mrs. Johnson, in this country, you are not allowed to leave underage children all by themselves.
Underage? Don't underestimate my daughters. Let Grace handle Amala for you. And you will know that the food is not underage.
Listen to me.
Okay.
This is United Kingdom.
Meaning we should not eat Amala.
If the government should find out that you are not taking good care of your children.
Wait. I am taking good care of my children.
But if the government should find out that underage children are left unattended all by themselves in this country, they'll be taken away from you.
What? What kind of policy is that?
I'm serious. Anyway, how is your father doing?
It's fine. Okay. It's okay.
That's fine. I guess this is not Nigeria. Things are quite different here, the way they do things.
Once again, I must say that you are excellent politician, Mr. Johnson. I love the
Olawale, sir.
I love the Deji.
No, I your Deji.
Can I just call you DJ?
Mr. Johnson, sir.
This is the communication panel.
Yes, sir.
The moment you notice that this green light comes red, you must be something on somewhere. Note it down and report it in the morning.
Yes, sir.
Does that make sense to you?
Yeah, definitely. Mr. Johnson, sir.
Please come with me. This is the electrical panel. Whenever you hear a triple, just come straight down here. Check the circuit breaker and you'll definitely see one that's gone off.
Yes.
Switch it on and everything will start to move.
Yes.
Is that okay?
Yes.
Mr. Ayodhi.
Mr. Ayodhi, sir.
Yes, sir. I don't even know what this is. You wouldn't be wearing this, you know, to work. We won't provide you with a uniform. So on your way out now, just go to the store. I'll give them the storeman a ring on the intercom to look for your side, which I believe they should have, and then you report for duty tomorrow night. So thank you very much. That'll be all, Mr. Yoni.
Mr. Johnson, sir.
Boy,
yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
All right.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you, sir.
Hey, this is my handsome young man.
I'll come and pick him up tomorrow morning.
Abby, are you not staying a while?
Are you seriously asking me that question?
Abby, there is no future in the past.
Exactly, Mom. No future in the past. And you're a big part of my past, so I see no future with you.
Why are you doing this? Why are you heartless? Abby, there is hope in Jesus.
You just say Jesus. And the Jesus lives in you, but I see no hope with you. You left me to rot and decay.
I never, and I will never.
Save it, Mom. I'm not down for this discussion.
Abby, listen to me.
My years of listening to you are long gone. Just make yourself useful. Take care of my son and don't repeat the same mistake you made with me 13 years ago.
Abby, please. Abby.
Yes, David.
How many wives does Grandpa have?
I'm the only one married to him. Why do you ask?
Some wives they have sleepover and mom calls them my uncle.
Uncle? Do you remember how many?
Sam. Uncle Rex, Uncle Natalia, Uncle Gabby, Uncle Roland, Uncle Sylvester Stallone.
Sylvester Stallone?
That's what he calls himself.
Do you know what I want you to do for me, Debbie? To pray for your mom. Yeah? Have your dream.
Your mom made me lose my job. Your mom would make me lose my job. She should be here by now. God. Oh God. Oh my God. Will make me lose my job.
I'm so sorry. Traffic everywhere. Terrible accidents in Halifax and Castle.
The bus pass. You know I can't go anywhere without the bus pass.
I know. I'm so sorry. Bye, Sugar.
No sugar at this time.
What happened? It's terrible. Traffic everywhere. Halifax and Castle.
And that is in the evening session. That gets underway around 7 o'clock local time.
Did you get a class on the back channel? Yes, I have Amy's copy on my mom's phone last night. Good. Can I have it? But mom warned us not to tune into that channel. I said, give it to me. Grace, that instruction was not for you, not for me. I am not a type in it, so give it to me.
Grand Slam single title to her past. Steffi Graf's open era record, she's in action 72. Against Karolina Pliskova. And that is in the...
Is this disobedience?
No, it's maturity.
What are we going to watch?
There's a show everyone's talking about in school. It starts in 10 minutes.
What's the show about?
Some girls in my class think that they're trapped in the wrong body. They should have came to this world as males, not females.
What?
Are you guys still awake? It's time to go to bed.
Mom, we're watching a sermon. It finishes soon.
Okay.
Who is preaching?
Mercy.
What?
Who is the preacher?
Grace is the preacher.
Okay. What is the preaching about?
It's about how girls feel they are more like guys. And they should have come to the world like guys.
Good.
What?
Nothing.
What? Woman. Ephesians 5, 22 to 23. Said, wife, submit to your husband. As unto the Lord. As unto the Lord. Just as the husband is the head of the wife. As Christ is the head of the church.
Do you realize you are shouting into my ears?
Let me shout, oh. Let me shout. Even if you have thrown away the African culture, would you also throw away the living word of God? The Bible has made it clear for those that have heaven in view.
Nothing you say will move me. Nothing you say will make me to change my mind. I am definitely going for that job interview. Okay?
The honorable duty of a wife and mother is to look after the affairs of your home and not to jump from one job to the other because your uncontrollable greed for pounds and pence. You will have to call that your office and cancel your shifts and go and pick my children.
Mr. Honorable, let's hear a word. Whenever you want this to fall on your side, that's why you remember Bible exists. This is London, not Africa. We all have equal rights. I have the right to work for my money, okay?
That is not what the Bible says, according to Ephesians.
Excuse me, Mr. Sebo, then Pastor.
Let me talk. A word of mouth is not effective for people like you. What you need is the living word of God, which is sharper than two-edged sword, capable of penetrating to your hardened and stony heart.
If you feel like quoting scriptures, wake up early in the morning and lead your family to morning devotion. When was the last time you did that?
Magoro. So you want me to lead morning devotion? Because I don't have any work to do in the morning, Abby.
I just realized talking with you is just waste of energy.
My brother, talking with me, waste of energy, word of God. Madam, what is even your salvation experience?
Hey, word of God, waste of energy.
How are you, my dear?
Very well, thank you, ma. Let me tell my husband that you're around. Yeah? Please take a seat.
Thank you.
I'm coming.
Thank you.
Grandma is in the sitting room.
Oh, my God.
What?
What's she doing here?
Ombimio.
Why should you hear that way? She's an old woman that is retired. She goes about engaging innocent people in meaningless talk like our fellow retirees. All she does is keep on talking stories upon stories.
Where are you going?
I am going to send her away.
Really?
Yes.
Send her out?
Yes, I have to send her away. I pay the bills here. Does she pay the bills? And if I don't do that, she goes about talking and talking, delaying me off my work. And she's so short-sighted, and she can't send me off the track.
How dare you call her short-sighted?
Relax, literate. She wears glasses, and she's short-sighted.
How dare you call me illiterate?
Well, I don't have room for sentiment. I'm going to walk her out, and nobody can stop me. Mama, oh, mama, oh, Oluwada, mama, sifuwa. Mama, oh, mama, oh, mama, oh, Oluwada, mama, sifuwa.
It is well with you, my son.
My sweet mommy. My one and only mommy. I missed you so much. It's been a while, Mama.
You have been too busy, Olawale.
It is a pleasure having you here, Mama.
I thought I should give you a surprise visit.
That is very kind of you.
Olawale, I did not see you in church last Sunday.
I was at work. They needed me.
Even Grace has not been coming to church. Not even the Sunday school.
That is very correct, Mama. My wife and I, we had to go and work. We were very busy.
Hey. So you have decided to sacrifice your Sunday to make more cash, Abby? You are very smart, Ojare, my son. But I love you.
I'm glad you understand that, Mama. It is not easy to make cash in this country, you know. We have to work hard.
Yeah, you have to work for more pounds to get more pounds.
I'm glad you understand.
Even in the bid of looking for more pounds and pay, in the process, sacrifice the life and destiny of your daughter?
Yes. No, no, Mama. No, 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 no. God forbid batting. Thank you very much for spending this time out of your tight schedule to come and pay us visit. We appreciate it so much, Mama. Thank you very much.
I am not ready to leave yet. Bring my bag back now. Come to tell you a story. Is there a problem?
No problem, Mama. On the contrary, I love your stories. One thing I love about those stories is the quick way you quickly tell your stories within a short time and pass a strong message. Mama, say about 5 minutes, you are done. It is always amazing.
Mr. Johnson, I am old enough to know that you don't want me here. However, the Holy Spirit has sent me here to deliver a strong message to you. I will advise you to calm down and listen to every word from an old woman. This morning, when I was taking my grandson to school, I saw Grace with a boy. The picture I saw was not pleasant.
Grace?
Yes, Grace.
My Grace?
Your Grace.
What picture did you see, Mama?
They were holding and cuddling themselves in the open.
Thank God it was even in the open. Grace, my daughter, we brought her up in the standards and way of the Lord. I am not denying or arguing what you saw. Perhaps she was with friends or even a classmate out there. No, Mama.
That's okay, Grandma. That's okay. Let me introduce her to you.
It's all right, Mama.
Her name is Abby. Please take care of Abby.
Oh, Abby.
Leave me alone and just get away from me.
Come on, Abby. This is our little secret, Abby. And I promise not to tell a single soul. Come on, open the door.
I will tell the police.
Oh, no, you wouldn't do that. Because if you do, they are going to take you away from your mom. And you will be miserable for the rest of your life. Now be a good girl and open the door.
Go away from me.
I give you 3 seconds to open this door. 1.
Mommy.
2.
Where are you, Mommy?
3.
No! No!
Come in, please. Oh, this is Sarah, please. Have your seat. I'll bring you shortly. Mrs. Sarah, we're going straight to the point. We've been conducting our own investigation into Abby's welfare, and our findings show that she hasn't received adequate care and attention.
What do you mean?
She tried to abort the baby locally, but one of her classmates carelessly leaked the secret to her teacher.
What? Oh.
It seems that you and your daughter are total strangers.
Oh dear you!
Our findings show that she's pregnant for one Mr. Keshi. We're assuming you're allowing to your house quite often.
No!
Mr. Keshi also seems to be under arrest currently, pending further investigation.
My daughter, my baby daughter, where is she?
Listen, Mrs. Sarah, following safeguard positions, we cannot allow Sarah to go home today. Social workers are at the reception, where there are also some documents you need to sign before you leave. I'm very sorry.
I am so sorry, Mama.
I did not tell you my story for you to be sorry for me. I just wanted to prevent another mistake.
Mm. But Grace is also a good girl.
I have not told you she is a bad girl.
I am very sure she will be innocent of all these accusations.
Okay. Have a good day.
My love.
I miss you, it's been so long.
I miss you too, it's been 3 hours and 30 minutes. It's no joke, you know. I was like, where's my love, where's my darling?
Hey, yeah, my father kept me.
Your father?
Yeah, he kept asking me lots of questions like, do I have a boyfriend, am I love?
What did you say?
I told him no. What?
You're a bad girl, you know.
Well, you're the boyfriend of a bad girl.
Blow me a kiss.
Mwah.
Mwah.
Is this the project you spent all night studying for? Who are you? I said, who are you?
Grace, you are such a disgrace! You were caught kissing a boy in school! What is she for? Oh my god!
This is a nightmare! At your age, when all your mates are busy studying and preparing for their future, you are destroying your destiny! What has come over you?
Thank God you are not in Africa! I would have beaten that demonic spirit out of you!
Grace, you?
And I can't imagine I was called upon to come and get this disgraceful letter.
Oh, you used to be a God-fearing girl. What has come over you?
You are such a shame. Since we are kissing now, what will you be doing when you get to college?
It will lie.
You
will
lie. See your daughter.
Daddy, you slapped me.
I slapped you. Hey, back. Go ahead. Call the police. I think it's better for me to be in jail than stay in this house with you.
Don't say that. How can you say that?
I am not going to that meeting. You have to go there, go to a school, and represent me in that
meeting. No way. No. I am not going to any meeting. I have an highlight shift on Monday. And besides, external supervisors are coming into our company, so I can't go.
Internal or external supervisor, or whatever you call it. You go there and represent me in this disgraceful meeting.
Mr. Supervisor, I am going to no meeting. I'm not going. And if you insist, take. Call the company and tell me that I will not be coming. After all, it's better for me not to even go to that meeting rather than stay within the same house.
That's not what I'm saying. I say just go and represent me in this meeting.
Julie, you go on school reports?
Yes, I do.
And Julie, you have a report?
Ready?
Mr. Bear, are you set?
Yeah?
Ready.
Good.
Come in, Mrs. Johnson. Please take your seat.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming. This is Miss Joy, the head teacher of the school. I'm Rose, Grace class teacher. And this is Julie, head of the year. And Ben, a representative from the social services. And myself, Chairman Governance Council. My name is Anne. Mrs. Johnson, your daughter is a very brilliant girl with promising future, but she is very wayward. We're here today because of safeguarding issues.
We are trying our best to train her in the right way.
We have noticed she always fell asleep at school.
That's not possible, ma.
Really?
It happened once.
Really?
Oh, sorry, twice.
According to our records, it has happened 3 times.
Oh, don't count the last one. It was due to the nature of my job.
We have also noticed that her parents look so untidy. She does not do her own work. This got us worried. So we have involved the service of social workers to carry out proper and professional investigation about our well-being at home.
It has not gotten to that. I promise from now on that will not repeat itself.
I'm afraid, Mrs. Johnson, Grace will not be going on with you today. She will have to stay temporarily with her foster parents whilst the investigation is going on.
What? I'm so sorry. I'm sorry.
Well, my advice will be you contact your lawyer and brief him about the incident.
Please, ma. That's not fair. I'm so sorry. Please help me. I don't want the government to take my child. Please help me.
From me.
Get out of this car now!
Anywhere you go, I'm going.
You must be out of your mind.
Abby, the devil stole your innocence 13 years ago.
God has come to restore you. I buried my past, mother.
Yes, you have buried your past. That is how it has grown into bitterness, hunger, hatred, unforgiveness. The Lord said, every fruit that he has not planted shall be uprooted.
I don't need him. I don't need you either.
Oh, yes, you do. The Bible says, come to me, all ye that labor and heavy laden, I will give you rest. The fruit of the past that you are carrying is too heavy for you. The Lord wants to help you.
Woman, you have overstayed your welcome. Get out. Get out of my car
now. There are two forces in this car fighting for your soul. It's you who have to choose who to follow.
Listen, woman, get out.
Make your choice.
Slow down, knife, now!
Are you mad?
No one dare point knife at my mom.
Her mom needs and I will shut her up.
You know I can kill you if you hurt her.
What? Abby, get out of my car now. Get out! Get out of my car! Get out! Get out, fuck you! Get out of my car! Get out! What are you doing? Get out of my car! Get out! She's still sleeping.
touch me.
Abby,
get away from me. Do you know what you just did in that car?
How about if you had stabbed you? Don't you know you're the only one I have left? Do you want him to kill you? Do you know you just risked your life for me?
I love you. Yeah? Christ has done more than that for us. That is why I'm going to take you home.
Not yet over. Christ can still win this battle.
How, Grandma?
If you cast your mind back to what I told you the first time you came, that my Bible said that if two of you shall agree on a thing, it shall be done by my Father in heaven. If you stand in one spirit, if you stand in one accord, you stand as a united front, you can still bring the daughter back.
Taking much of your time?
Not at all. I've really learned a lot from the story you've told me.